In today's tutorial, I will show you 10 best CapCut tricks that will take your video editing skills from beginner level to pro level just using your mobile phone. The first CapCut effect is color isolation. Color isolation is all about making one color to stand out. And in this my video, I'm going to make my car the red color to stand out from other colors. And this color isolation gives your video a cinematic look. Now to do that, click on this your video here. Then go over to adjust, click on adjust, then go over to HSL, click on HSL, then I'm going to leave this red and I'm going to be clicking on other colors. I'll go over to green and I'm going to reduce the saturation. Then I'll go over to yellow here, I'm going to reduce the saturation too. And I'm going to reduce the lightness. I will go over to this yellow again, reduce the saturation, reduce the lightness. Then you can see my color is changing. Then I'll go over to red and I'm going to increase the saturation. I've increased it. Okay, so that is it. So you can see our video. You can see that color isolation give it this cinematic vibe. The next effect is text behind video. To add text behind your video, the first thing you have to do is to import your clip and then go over to text, click on it. Then I'm going to add my text by clicking on this add text here. Then I'll write my text. Okay, I'm going to push it up a little bit here. I'm going to keep it here. Then the next thing I'm going to do, I want to animate my text. First of all, I'm going to stretch this text. Okay, then I'll go over to animation. I'll click on animation. Then I'm going to choose wipe right animation. You can choose any animation of your choice. I'll click on this wipe right. Then I will increase the duration a little bit. I don't want it to be that fast. Okay. Then I'm going to export it. I'll click on this up arrow. And I'll click on save to device. Once it is saved, I will go back and import my video. So here is my first video. You can see it. Business as usual. Then I'll click on overlay here. I'll click on this overlay, add overlay to add this video. Here is my main video without text. So I'm going to zoom it a little bit, increase the size. They are equal now. You can do it by pinching it with your hand. So I'm going to click on this video, the overlay. I'll go over to remove background. I'll click on remove background. And I'll click on auto removal. Okay, they are equal. You can see our text behind the person. The next effect is tracking. To make your text to follow your object, the first thing you have to do is to write out your text. I'll go over to text and I'll click on it. Then I'll click on add text to add my text. So I'm going to drag it up to this place and reduce the size by pinching it here. Then I'll click OK. Then I'm going to stretch this text to the end of my video clip. Now I'll go over to track and I'll click on it. Then I'll carry this lens and I'll keep it here. Just keep it to the object you want your text to track. Then click on start tracking. So you can see as he's moving, the text is moving along with him. The next effect is 3D camera effect. To add 3D camera effect to your flat screen video, all you have to do is go over to your animation. Click on this animation. Then go over to combo. Click on combo. We are going to search for 3D flip. So you can see this 3D flip here, flip 5, flip 3. I prefer the flip 3. I will click on this flip 3 here. You can see my video. Then I will click on this mark. Then to increase the size of this video, all you have to do is just pinch it a little bit to make it a little bit bold, depending on the size you want. Okay, you can see our video now. The next test effect is adding video in text. To add video inside our test, the first thing we have to do is to write our test. So I'm going to click on add test to write my test here. So I'll go over to font to change my font. So I'm going to stretch this text to this place. Then I want to add animation to my text. I'll click on animation here. I'm going to add concentrate. I'll click on concentrate. I want to stretch it, make the duration. I will reduce it. Okay. So let's export this video now. So I'm going to come over here to import my text. So here is my text. I'm going to click overlay to import the video. Then I'll come over to my overlay video. I'll click on this video here. Then I'll go over to blend. Click on blend. Then I'm going to click on darken. So you can see my video inside my text. The next effect is object floating effect. To create an object floating effect in CapCut, all you have to do is go over to effect, click on it, then click on video effect, search for play pendulum. Then click on play pendulum here. Then I'm going to stretch my effect to my video. Then you can see that my object is not moving. To make this object to move, go over to object, click on object and click on this overlay here. So you can see my object is now moving. So this is how to be able to add a floating effect on your object. Smooth zooming effect. To create a zoom in and out effect on your video, click on your video, then add the first keyframe. Then I'll go down here. Then I'm going to zoom in a little bit. I'll pinch my video to zoom in a little bit. Then I'll go over to this place. I'm going to zoom out by pinching it out. You can see the camera movement in my video. The next effect is progress bar animation. So I'm going to show you how to add a progress bar to your video. This progress bar helps you to track your progress and also to estimate the time that is remaining. To do that, click on text, add text, and I'm going to be adding underscores. So if your underscore is not joined together, you can go over to style here, click on it, then click on this style, go over to spacing, then over to this character. If you increase the character, you can see the lines, the underscore are separated. But if you reduce it, it will be joined together. So I'm going to reduce it to minus 10. Then I'm going to increase the scale, the height, you can see it. Then I'm going to make sure that I stretch this, my line here, so that it will reach to the end, from this end to the end of the video. Yeah, I will increase the size. Okay, it's okay now. Then I'll go over to my spacing. They want to increase the size of the progress bar, the height. So it's okay like this. Then I love red. I'm going to change the color. I'll go over to text. Then go over to color red. I'm going to change it to red. The next thing I'm going to do is that I'm going to click on this animation. Then I'll look for wipe right. Make sure that you stretch the duration to the end of the video. The next effect is cinematic intro. To create a cinematic intro, first of all, write to your text. So I'm going to scale it a little bit. Then I'm going to stretch it to the end. So I'll go back and import my text. Then I'll click on this. Then I'll go over to Max. I'll click on Max. Then I'll choose Mirror Max. Then I'll come over to Adjust. I'm going to rotate it a little bit. I'll keep it at -74. Then I'll come over to my video and I'm going to put my first keyframe. Then I'll go over to the last and I'm going to drag it towards the end. And zoom it out. The next effect is split test animation effect. To create a split test animation effect, first of all, we have to write our test. I'll click on test, then add test. I'm going to write my test. I'll go over to style, over to the size, I'll reduce it. Then I'll make sure that my test is centered. Then I'll increase it back. Once my test is centered, I'm going to stretch this my test to match the duration of this clip. Then I'll click on export to download my test video. So I'll go ahead and upload my video here. So I'll go ahead and click overlay to import my text video. So I'm going to increase it to be the exact size with the video. I'm going to cut it out from this side. Then I'll come back to my test here. I'm going over to blend. I'll click on blend. And I will choose lightning. So I'll go over a little bit. Then I'm going to click on split. For the rest part, I'll click on the rest part here, the rest part of the text. I'll go over to mask. I'll click on horizontal mask. Then I'll come over and add my first keyframe. Then I'll go to the end. And I'm going to pull this up. So I'll go ahead and duplicate this part. I'll click on it and go over to duplicate. And I'll bring it down as an overlay. Then I'll come over here and remove our last keyframe. Then I'll click on this text video and I'll go over to mask. and I'll click on invert. So to add the last keyframe, I'll put this down here. So this is how to achieve your split test animation effect in CapCut. So if you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel.